don't miss any content, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Sahara Football, as usual, it's a fine morning here. Today's video is going to be a bit different. I'm going to do a little analysis on an issue that has come up to me, that has been brought to my attention, that is kind of bothering me, and I would like to share it with you and get your opinions on it. As usual, I'm your host, Selas Fiawi, and welcome back to Sahara Football. So let me just get right into it. So yesterday, a news article was released. The news was making the rounds that a Ghanaian player, Stuart Nketiah, he plays for Arsenal, played for the England youth teams before, and Nketiah reportedly has rejected Ghana because of something they did to him. Let me just read a story for you to see. Arsenal youngster Edward Nketiah has reportedly told Ghana coach Kwesi Appiah that he isn't interested in playing for the country. Kwesi Appiah met with a young Edward Nketiah in Iceland to discuss about his international future and the possibility of playing for the Ghana Black Stars, but the talented forward said that he has no plans of playing for Ghana and will pursue his international career with England. The player believes he has been playing well for England junior teams and thinks he can improve to have a real opportunity with the England side. Now, further reports suggest that Nketiah's decision is shaped by Ghana's refusal to let him play for the Ghana under 17 side 3 years ago. As the story goes, family of Nketiah flew to Ghana to discuss the possibility of the pushing of the youngster into the Ghana under 17 side, but were asked to pay some money before the inclusion. The family refused to adhere to the committee's request and flew back to the United Kingdom. Nketiah has scored 18 goals for England under 18, under 19, under 20, and under 21 levels, and is highly rated by technical members of the England national team. Yes, so this is the story that made me want to do this video, and my question is playing for the Black Stars a bad thing? Is playing for the Ghana national team, is it a bad thing? Does it derail a player's career? I'm saying this because when I posted this story on social media, the reactions I was getting was, yes, it's a good decision he made, and that the Ghana national team doesn't offer any value to players in general, and that immediately you join the national team, your career tends to go sideways. Immediately you take the national team 100% serious, your career tends to go sideways, and that it's a positive thing Nketiah did. Now, since the story broke, Nketiah's family have come out to deny the claims that this is not true. This is a screenshot of a Facebook comment reportedly posted by Nketiah's father. He's labeling what has been posted on social media and other tabloids headlines that it's utter total gutter journalism. I don't know whether he was reacting to this story because it doesn't show here in the screenshot, or he was reacting to something else, but there could be some element of truth in it, but that is beside the point. This is not the first time we are hearing something like this. Callum Hudson-Odoi, we know, is not going to play for Ghana. Danny Welbeck chose England over Ghana. Mario Balotelli chose Italy over Ghana. So I can continue with the list. It's so many players who, given the opportunity, have chosen the other country in place of Ghana. Now I want to know if Ghana playing for the Ghana Black Stars is something which is not positive for a player, or it's not good for a player's career. Now I've did some analysis and went through the history, and I saw that it all stems down to a few issues that we have, but there are some things that have happened in the past that brought my attention to this. Now you all remember Dominic Adia. Now Dominic Adia was a great player for the under 20 side. He led the under 20 side to World Cup victory in 2009. He was the highest goal scorer, and I think he was the best player of the tournament as well. Now Dominic Adia since then had requests to play for clubs like AC Milan and so many others. But where is Dominic Adia now? That's my question. Where is he now? The system in place here in this country does not accommodate nurturing of talents. There are so many players who are talented at the under 17, under 20, under 23 level who don't develop and reach the potential they should. There are too many people falling out the cracks, and I think the national team system in place is not helping. Another player I can also think of is Junior Agogo. Now, Junior Agogo was a star of the 2008 that Ghana hosted here. But a year ago, I brought a story on this channel and that revealed that Junior Agogo had been neglected by the national team, by his players, by his teammates, and was suffering from stroke. His mother was the only one taking care of him. After dedicating so much of his life to the national team, you would think he would be someone who would be celebrated and revered. I have outlined some few issues I think that are the cause of this, and I would like to share them with you. You can let me know your thoughts in the comments box. I might be wrong. This is just a rant. We are learning from each other, and I stand to be corrected. Now, my number one problem is the country. The country here, we are raised to focus more on money than the service delivered. That's why you have players who have lost their first game to the United States of America in the 2014 World Cup. They lost their very first game to the United States of America in the 2014 World Cup. And they are able to demand for money when they couldn't provide the result at the beginning. Yes, I would get to the other side of the story where they were told that they'd be given this and that and they were not delivered. But when you look at the whole story here, we are in a, I am talking about Ghana. I can only speak for Ghana. I don't know about African countries, but it's like the focus is more on money than what you, the service you have delivered. Players who don't deliver on a daily basis. That's why you have something like Mubarak Wakaso will leave the camp during the friendlies in May. Wakaso left the camp because money that was given them wasn't plenty according to him. Now Wakaso also left the camp. Another player also left the camp along with Wakaso. That was a free aqua of Empoli left the camp with Wakaso because they did not like the package that was being given to the players for a friendly game, not a tournament game, a friendly game. The focus here for most players in Ghana is to secure the bag first. Yes, I know the importance of money, but you should also back your request for the money with the performances. Now, in the 2018 World Cup qualifier, when we drew with GR Congo in Kumasi, Asamoah was interviewed and said we were not motivated enough for a World Cup qualifier. What other motivation could you need for a World Cup qualifier? It's quite baffling. Now, my next issue is honesty. Honesty in going through with the agreed upon contract. In the case of the Wakaso leaving camp in May because of the money that was given them, you would go back and realize that they were told they'll be given this money, then they come back to camp and they are being told a different story. We are not honest with the players. We are not honest if we don't follow through with our word. Our word should be one and the same throughout. They will say they'll give you this, then they'll change their minds and give you that. That is also no good. This applies the same thing that happened in 2014 World Cup. Contracts were agreed upon, payments were agreed upon, then you backtrack on those stuff. People pay bills, the players also pay bills, and they have families to look after. The system is not great here. The system of player development is not also great here for the juvenile leagues. Nurturing of talent, as I said. Now, we had a breakout star, Karama Abdullahi, at the Under-17 Women's World Cup. We've had a lot of amazing people, women's football, here at the Under-17 Women's World Cup, and we don't know where they ended up. Inability to track those talents, to nurture them, to make sure that they get the best of attention and care, to make sure that they are wanted. We have to show them that we want them, and we have to do everything possible to keep them in the national team. And I don't think we are doing enough in that respect. Now, to some extent, playing for Ghana is not the most ideal, but we are the ones who made it so. Yeah. Playing for Ghana might not be the most ideal for a player's career. The national team might not provide you the things you want, the monies you want. But playing for the national team is not about making money. That's what I also know. Your club football is for that. Your club career is for that. Your national team is about the love you have for your country. And I feel players have to be told this, have to understand from the youth level that playing for your country is a privilege. I don't know why Edward Nketiah will be asked to pay some money to play for the national team. That's another part side from the authorities. If that there's some truth to that, I don't know. But if that these reports are true, I'll be really disappointed. Why should he have to pay to play for the national team? I don't get it. It just doesn't make sense to me. This is quite unfortunate for me. It's just a little issue I wanted to address. And as I said, we are the ones who made it so, and we are the ones who can make it better. There is no pure or impure land. Ghana can be better with our own efforts. We have to make the difference. We have to be the difference we want to see. We should not neglect the talent. Our local football too shouldn't be neglected. Speaking of local football, I've heard the normalization committee has rejected a suggestion from the Premier League clubs to play alone in the special competition. They don't want to play with the Division 1 clubs, which I don't get. So the competition might not happen on the 26th as expected. It will be dragged. The issue is still being discussed, and the clubs have today to respond, the end of today to respond. So that's it, guys. Do you think playing for the Ghana national team is bad? And let me know why. What do you think we can do differently as a country? Outline some players here. Dominica Dia, Junior Agogo, Suleiman Tari. Because of the altercations that happened in 2014, he has been suspended from the Black Stars. And Kevin Prince Boateng. The country's system is bad. So the systems don't work, the people won't work. But if the systems work, the people will work. Let me know your thoughts in the comment box on this issue. Now, before I go, let me just give you a few information on the stories I have. Now, we have a new breaking out star, and he's called Benjamin Tete. Now, Benjamin Tete is 6'4". He's a 21-year-old and plays for Sparta Prague. Now, unknown English Premier League clubs are reported to have circled the red-hot Ghanaian youth international striker Benjamin Tete. The Sparta Prague player is on a purple patch scoring form in the Czech Republic. He has scored 9 goals in 15 matches. Tete's style of play has been likened to Didier Drogba by a former Chelsea star. He's a 6'4" centre forward, and he's said to be the wishlist of Turkish side Galatasaray. According to the Daily Mail, Galatasaray coach Faith Kerim is understood to be a fan and has earmarked the young Ghanaian's number one option for his window. This is our Ghanaian Zlatan Ibrahimovic. His height 6'4". I hope this guy, this talent, will be nurtured and that he will be maintained and given the necessary attention he needs. Asante Kotoko at the Kotoko International Airport right now. Cameroon to face Cotton Sport in the CAF Confederations Cup on Sunday. And they are here in your pictures right now. They are at the Kotoko International Airport. They first take a flight to Togo, then they'll travel onwards to Cameroon. That has been it for today, guys. I've been ranting a little. Let me know your thoughts in the comments box. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.